Nothing here to fear. I'm just sitting around being foolish when there is work to be done. Just a hang-up call and the quiet
Hey guys, so today I want to talk about animal use versus animal abuse. There tends to be two sections of animal rights, and it tends to be welfarist and abolitionist. I had covered about how I didn't like to call myself an abolitionist before, but I essentially am an abolitionist. I believe that using animals is wrong, regardless of whether there is abuse going on or not. The problem is, for me, there's a lot of fine lines. Some people are really strongly against pet ownership, such as me having a kitty is not abolitionist, but I think that the problem is it's at this point so much damage has been done. We have so many strays in this world now that I believe adoption is a must. It has to be done. There's just no other way other than to kill these animals, which don't deserve that. The welfarist view is more of coming with humane means of taking care of animals. They believe that, you know, we shouldn't abuse animals, but we still have the right to use them. And abolitionists believe we should not use animals, period. Animal use, the biggest issues with it, in my eyes, is that you are putting an animal below someone else. So humans have the dominant control over another sentient being's life. The thing is as I said, you know, there's a big overpopulation problem now. You know, cats and dogs are being euthanized every day in shelters by the thousands, and it's awful. So again, we have to take responsibility. And the biggest problem with that is we got to stop the breeding. We have to stop bringing these animals into this world when, you know, there's no need. There's just not enough people wanting these animals, and people deciding they'd rather get a purebred dog than a shelter animal that's going to be euthanized. And it's selfish. It's pure selfishness. Go further into this, it's also with, you know, cows and pigs and chickens and all of the domestic animals. And, you know, you get a lot as a vegan that, well, what would happen if we didn't use them? Like, they just go free and overpopulate the world, which that wouldn't happen. It's a matter of freeing them. It's just a matter of giving them a life that they should naturally have. I believe in, you know, if we could transfer them into animal shelters and sanctuaries and give them happy lives, you know, where we're not stealing their children and we're not taking their eggs and their milk and using them for meat and clothing. Obviously, all these things are not realistically going to happen overnight regardless. I just wanted to cover the topic because I feel that it is important to outline use versus abuse. I basically started thinking about a lot of this. I mean, it's stuff I think about every day anyways, but recently there was another investigation into a dairy farm in Chilliwack, BC. I've actually been to Chilliwack, so it's a place I know. I am so thankful for organizations like Mercy for Animals because they really do bring out truths about, you know, companies. And the brilliant thing is that we have a division here in Canada that does these investigations. So I hear so often that, oh, but these things don't happen in Canada. And yes, they do. And I like that Mercy for Animals kind of sheds light on, you know, it's not just happening in the United States. It's not just happening in these, you know, these places that you just don't know. It's happening in small towns all across Canada. I got frustrated by this company in Chilliwack, the dairy organization there, you know, released statements about how they had no idea this was going on, and they're appalled and shaken by it, and, you know, all these typical excuses. The problem is these things won't change because you're putting a dollar sign on a sentient being. These companies, no matter how they like to portray their happy cows and their happy chickens and their smiling pigs on the side of a pork truck, these are not happy places for animals. You are using an animal for profit. You care about dollars over lives. That is fact. And regardless of how nice these animals were treated, which I'm telling you, most of these places are not treating their animals nicely, you still have a dominance over a sentient being that is not, it's not correct, it's not right. Whether you like hearing comparisons or not, having ownership over an animal is no different than having ownership of a child and that child not having any right. Now, if a child is abused or neglected or molested or anything like that, they have a lot more power to go in and help that child than there is to go in and help an animal that is going through the same kinds of things. First off, because of cognitive dissonance, moral schizophrenia, society deems a child more important than a cow, and it is ingrained in people's heads that humans are somehow more superior to an animal, which humans are animals, regardless whether you think it or not. You think that we are more intelligent, that we somehow have the right to treat an animal this way, and that it's just a dumb animal, so they don't know. But I can tell you that humans and any other animal have much more in common than we do have differences. We all feel pain. We all feel pleasure. We all want love. We all have a heart, a brain. We all have the desire for food, for water, for shelter, for every basic need that you possibly have. An animal has those too. The only difference is the way we look. Intelligence does not define whether an animal deserves their basic instincts to be met. Intelligence does not define whether something feels pain. No one has the right to decide whether something lives or dies. These animals, from the time they're born, have their time of death stamped on them. They have no choice. They can't escape. And we just choose to ignore it. We choose to take the easy route and pretend it's not happening. We choose to satisfy our own pleasure before thinking of where that pleasure even came from. I just want you to ask yourself what makes you so much more important than the life of any other animal on this planet. Why do you think you deserve everything and these animals deserve nothing? Why is abuse so much harder to watch for people than death? Somebody would rather see them slitting the throat of a cow than them beating on it with a stick. Somehow abuse is more painful for people to see than death is. Regardless of how you treat something, it makes no difference in the end if you're just gonna kill it anyways. There's no reason for any of this. We live in a time where you can easily go into the grocery store and buy a plant-based milk. You can easily pick up a pack of veggie dogs over hot dogs. You can easily bake cakes without eggs and milk and any other animal product. There's no reason other than normality and apathy and just not caring one way or the other. All animal products are misery. It doesn't matter where they come from. It doesn't matter if it is a little family farm, which I'm telling you doesn't exist anymore. There's very few around now that actually treat animals nicely, but even if they do, they're still putting a dollar sign on that animal. And I don't know about you, but I don't think that's right for a sentient being. It's no more right than a man owning a woman, a person owning an African for a slave, or owning a child to do with what they wish. It's no different. Think about it. Thanks for watching. See you next time.